Hello, everyone. This is Bill Keegan, town manager in Foxborough, contacting you with the latest COVID update for the town of Foxborough. First, the statistics. In Massachusetts, we now have 777 confirmed cases of COVID-19, and that is up from 646 from the day before, an increase of 131 cases statewide. In Norfolk County, we have 82 confirmed cases, and that is up from 75 cases the day before. That is an increase of just 7 cases. We had six people contract the disease the day before that. So we're in that area of 6 to 7 cases per day. In Foxborough, it's unfortunate to report, but we do have our first confirmed case, and we think we may have a second one that may be determined later this week. But we just wanted to get you updated on that piece. As of noon today, Governor Baker advised us. There was an advisory this afternoon. His latest press update was given, and there was new legislation being filed by the Baker Polito administration to help municipalities specifically. And we're looking through that. We're on a conference call a few minutes ago, seeing how that would work for cities and towns. So as soon as I have that confirmed legislation, I'll be able to report to you some of the more details, greater details of how that legislation is actually working. One of the things that I wanted to report to you, though, was and it seems to be that it is a little concerning to see how the cases in Massachusetts are broken down. And while there's been a lot of talk about the fact that the disease itself actually, or the virus itself, has actually impacted the elderly population more significantly, actually in Massachusetts the numbers don't reflect that. And in fact, from the age group of 40 to 49, the number of cases in Massachusetts is 152. And the second highest number of cases in the age group of 50 to 59, which is 141. And if you look at that, if you go even younger than that, the cases are actually quite significant as well. So there is no particular age group where in Massachusetts at least, where it is an indication that we are being somehow protected. I think the lowest number of cases is in the age group from 1 to 19, and of course, and even that seems relatively high in some regards too. So I would just make note of that we do encourage everyone to continue to use, to stay at home and to utilize good hygiene practices while you're at home, and if you do go out into the public to go to the store or whatever the case may be. Also, of great note too, and this has been reported on several different instances, is that be very mindful of the fact when you go to get gas for your car that you take appropriate steps to protect yourself when using the gas pump itself. Make sure that you either wear a glove or take some sort of a barrier that's used against the pump itself while pumping gas, because it's been determined that the COVID-19 virus can actually live on the pump itself for some period of time, and so be mindful of that when you're using the pumps, to make sure you take appropriate cautions in doing that. Of the cases in Massachusetts, there are 79 cases that are hospitalized, 286 that are not hospitalized, and 412 that are still being investigated further. So I wanted to also, just from a more positive perspective, give you an idea of some of the things that we are doing. We're going to moving to more of a mobile workforce here in Foxborough, and many of the staff members are starting to work from home. And we've been trying to work through that throughout the course of this week, working on their work plans for home, so they can actually continue to get work done, answering calls and continuing to provide services to the public as needed. We're also asking them to work on specific projects. For instance, what we're having them work on is a plan where they will actually evaluate all aspects of what they do and document all those steps and all those activities, so they can actually then document it and have it for a book that will be maintained in the office and for that specific position. So we're calling what is was referred to as the truck binder, and more or less a binder that includes, and we use that term because it actually breaks it down. But it's rhetorically speaking, it's sort of like a binder which is using in the event that something rather dramatic happened to a person, and the person was gone, and next person had to fill in to that position, then we would have something actually to go by. So this is something that we've decided is an important project for us to work on while folks are working on it from home and not being interrupted on a more regular basis as they typically would. Also, in the Council on Aging, there is a teleconference bingo that's starting to be done at 1:30 every Tuesday, starting on this Tuesday. And there were about 500 letters sent out to seniors to let them know that that is available to them. And we're going to see how that plays out, and hopefully that'll be a very successful event. If those who want to join the Foxborough 60 Plus Facebook group, you can do that. You can go online and type in the Foxborough 60 Plus Facebook group, and you can join that group. Right now, there are almost 400 members in just the past 5 days. So that's increasing rather dramatically. On Friday at 12 p.m. There will be a teleconference call to check in with seniors as well. That number is 1-612-746-7381, and the code is 567-670. 567-670. It'll be an opportunity to stay in touch with seniors, and it shouldn't be any longer than a 15 to 20 minute conversation. So we encourage seniors particularly to do that. In HESCO, there are plenty of drivers for the Meals on Wheels program as it currently stands. However, we do ask residents to monitor this closely, and I'll continue to update you on this, that we also may need some additional drivers as the situation evolves. But right now, we do have enough drivers, and we'll continue to keep you updated on that. There are plenty of things that staff members are continuing to do, answer questions that continue to come out about the virus. Residents are obviously limited to what they can do. Only the stores that are providing essential services are actually open to the public at this point in time. We have grocery stores, gas stations, banks are still open providing services. But based upon Governor Baker's direction as of yesterday, as of noon time today, only those stores with essential services are continuing to be remain open. If anybody has a question about what that means, there is a definition that actually can be of what essential services means, but there is there it's actually it's not as easy as it appears. There are some things that are subject to interpretation, and we are working with folks to try and clarify that. But the key thing is to make sure that whatever store is open, that the social distancing is maintained at all time, and that residents and folks that are living here in Foxborough or even outside of Foxborough should maintain that at all time, and also maintain the washing of the hands and proper distancing at all times, so that we continue to try and keep the community safe and residents safe in throughout this in this region and entire. Entire state and entire country for that matter. So we're trying to. This is a battle that none of us have ever seen before. So we're actually going to continue to work through it on day by day basis. I'll continue to provide you updates as they come available. We apologize for some of the technical difficulties we had earlier in the show. We tried a couple of times and realized that we had some difficulties with maintaining the getting the video. Voiceover to get to work. So we figured that out. We're back on live for you today. We tried to do the show at noontime, but it seems that the governor likes to do his updates at noontime, and then there were other video conferences or phone conferences that we were working off through with the MMA, the Mass Municipal Association, which started at 1 o'clock. So we may go back to what I think is probably the best times to do it around 3 o'clock. And to give you an update on what's happening at that time. So I want to say thank you for now. If anyone does have questions that they would like to run by us, feel free to give me a send me an email at bkeegan@foxborough.org. Foxborough, Foxbourough, ma.gov. That's B. Keegan at Foxborough, spelled the old-fashioned way, ma.gov. For now, stay safe, and hope you all continue to maintain through this difficult situation that we have, and we'll be here for you if you need us. So long for now.